For 8 seasons, we have been obsessed with Game of Thrones and finding out what is going to happen next. As the show finally comes to an end, we thought we'd take a moment to consider the lives of the cast who have brought so many of our favorite characters to life. And don't worry, we'll also include some of the actors who play people we can't stand. Did Sophie Turner really elope in Vegas? Which Game of Thrones moment did Maisie Williams' boyfriend hate? Find out the answers to all of these questions and many more. Saying Sansa Stark has been unlucky in love is the understatement of the century, but luckily, real life is rarely as horrible as Game of Thrones, and there are definitely far less dragons flying around. But still, Sophie Turner had a difficult time coping with the sudden fame and frequent criticism she received when she started working on the show. Reaching out to her loved ones helped tremendously, and among them was Joe Jonas. These two have been dating since November 2016, and they officially tied the knot in a rather unorthodox way. After the 2019 Billboard Music Awards, they got married in Vegas, with Joe's brothers Nick and Kevin in attendance. According to her new sister-in-law, Priyanka Chopra, this wild wedding perfectly encapsulated the couple's personalities. Although they made it official already, these two are planning a much fancier and formal affair during the summer in France. Sophie Turner has always shouted her love for Joe Jonas from the rooftops, but when it comes to relationships, her Game of Thrones bestie Maisie Williams takes a different approach. And it makes sense, really, since we all know Sansa Stark can't keep a secret, and Arya Stark is the sneakiest person in the Seven Kingdoms. Maisie was linked to Ollie Jackson for about a year when they suddenly unfollowed each other on social media and stopped hanging out. As of May 2019, she's been linked to Reuben Selby, but so far we have nothing but rumors to go on. So what details will Maisie admit about her love life? Well, apparently her partner wasn't a fan of Arya's big season 8 moment on Game of Thrones. He thought Jon Snow should have had the moment instead, and Maisie's fans were not having it. Without even knowing who this guy is, they called for Maisie to break up with him. We're not sure if Maisie heard the war cry of "dump him, sis," or not, and we wonder how many relationships have ended due to Game of Thrones related issues. Emilia Clarke plays the role of Starbucks lover Daenerys Targaryen on Game of Thrones. Like Maisie Williams, Emilia prefers to keep things quiet when it comes to her personal life. After filming the first season of the show, she experienced a life-threatening aneurysm and kept it from the public for years. If she could keep that hidden, just imagine how secretive she can be about her dating life. In 2018, she was linked to Charlie McDowell, but the two never did more than interact on social media, and now they're not following each other. Prior to that, in 2013, she was rumored to be dating Family Guy creator Seth MacFarlane for about 6 months. However, allegedly the distance and their busy careers caused them to part ways. She was also linked to big-name star James Franco, and it was even rumored that they were engaged. However, Emilia claimed that they had only met twice, which barely makes them acquaintances. Jared Leto was spot flirting with her at the SAG Awards, but we can't say for sure if she reciprocated his obvious interest. It seems for now fans are just going to have to wait and wonder if Emilia is seeing anyone. Everyone's favorite Lannister, Peter Dinklage, has been married for quite some time to theater director Erica Schmidt. He has thankfully been much luckier in love than his Game of Thrones character Tyrion Lannister. Peter and Erica tied the knot in 2005 and have since had 2 children together. Although they're always glowing about one another, they're much more tight-lipped when their kids are concerned. Their first child was a girl born in 2011, and the couple never released her name to the public. There was a rumor going around that she is named Zelig, which Peter laughed off as being untrue. Kit Harington's character Jon Snow was frequently chastised for knowing nothing, notably by his on-screen love, Ygritte. But behind the scenes, Kit was getting close with the actress who played her, Rose Leslie. Like many couples on the show, these two didn't get to have their on-screen happily ever after, which was sad but not exactly surprising. However, we're happy to say things have gone much better for Kit and Rose in real life. The two fell in love on set, and their love story thankfully didn't end when filming wrapped up. They finally went public with their relationship in 2016, and would only comment that they were very happy together. They were married in June of 2018, and very appropriately held the reception at Wardcliffe Castle. But this next Game of Thrones star can relate to going through some romantic difficulties. Lena Headey has had more than her fair share of heartbreak in real life, but at least she dates outside of her family, unlike Cersei Lannister. She married musician Peter Lochran in May of 2007, and the two had a son named Wiley in 2010. However, the marriage didn't last, and the divorce was exceptionally bitter. Lena struggled with postpartum depression and was reportedly broke during this difficult period in her life. She momentarily found love again with her Game of Thrones co-star Jerome Flynn, who plays Bronn, but sadly this didn't last either. Things were so bad between them, they refused to even appear in the same scenes together on the show. But don't pour yourself another goblet of wine just yet. Lena eventually got together with her childhood friend, director Dan Caden. The two had a daughter named Teddy together in 2015 and married 3 years later in 2018. Gwendolyn Christie played the brave Brienne of Tarth, who was often mocked due to her appearance. In real life, Gwendolyn was often told she would never make it as an actress because of her tall stature. Thank goodness she kept trying, because we couldn't imagine anyone else playing the role of Brienne. And who else could have had that, intense on-screen chemistry with Tormund Giantsbane? In real life, she's been dating fashion designer Giles Deacon since 2013. He doesn't seem to mind that at just over 6'3", Gwendolyn towers over him. Giles and Gwendolyn like to keep their relationship private, but Gwendolyn has bragged about him on more than one occasion. She lauds his talent in the world of fashion and for just being an awesome human being. We're just glad it seems like Gwendolyn has better luck in love than poor Brienne. As a testament to his acting ability, Alfie Allen made us all despise Theon Greyjoy before making us all fall in love with him. Alfie is the son of a film producer and an actor, and his older sister is none other than singer Lily Allen. In 2017, some photos emerged of Alfie getting close with a beautiful blonde woman while on vacation in Formentera, Spain. Eventually, it was revealed that this was American DJ and model Allie Teals. It turns out these two had been in a relationship since 2016 and were head over heels in love with each other. Before starting a family with Allie, Alfie had been in an on-again, off-again relationship with Jamie Winstone for 7 long years. They even got engaged in 2008 before calling it off 2 years later in 2010. Maybe Alfie was just holding out for someone whose name jives so perfectly with his own. Nikolai Coster Waldau was known for playing the role of an alternatively hateable and lovable Jaime Lannister on Game of Thrones. He's been married since all the way back in 1997 to actress and singer Nukaka. These two now have a happy marriage, but according to Nikolai, it didn't start out easy. He was smitten with Nukaka the moment they met, but she took some convincing. Eventually, his persistence paid off, and the two married and had 2 daughters together. Despite being a fan of Nikolai, Nukaka has never seen a single episode of Game of Thrones. According to Nikolai, she finds it too strange to watch her husband pretending to be someone else on TV. That makes a little bit of sense, but we still think she's missing out. We all know that sometimes co-stars fall in love while on set. This worked out well for Kit Harington and Rose Leslie, but just because two characters smooch on screen doesn't mean the actors are dating. Natalie Emmanuel played the role of Missandei, who fell in love with the unsullied soldier Grey Worm. There were rumors about something going on with Natalie and Jacob Anderson behind the scenes, but these were never proven to be more than just gossip. Okay, it may be equal parts gossip and wishful thinking. These two are awfully cute together on screen, but we doubt Jacob's wife would have been very happy about this. Don't worry, we'll talk about her a little bit later. According to Natalie, her career actually makes it more difficult to find love since she's always moving around. She says people often find her fame intimidating, which is maybe why she prefers to keep her relationships private. She was often seen with actor Alex Lanapekin, and the two even went on a romantic Italian vacation together. However, in 2019, the two suddenly stopped making so many appearances together. While there's been no word on an official split, some believe their romance might be over. Carice Van Houten is another Game of Thrones star who claims acting can be detrimental at times. She played the role of the Red Woman, Melisandre, who many fans found quite bewitching. But in real life, Carice found happiness with actor Guy Pearce. They met on the set of the movie Brimstone in 2016 and found sparks immediately flew between them. Guy had recently gotten a divorce from his ex-wife, Kate Mestiz, and Carice helped him move on from that tough situation. It seems like finding love on set is a thing for Carice. She had met her previous partner, actor Sebastian Koch, on the set of Black Book. Despite this, Carice claims she isn't a fan of the Hollywood lifestyle and prefers living in Europe. She's found happiness there with Guy and their son, Monty. We all know that, sadly, Tormund Giantsbane's love for Brienne of Tarth was unrequited. Honestly, we're not sure whether it's sadder for Brienne, Tormund, or the audience. But things are much happier for actor Christopher Heavey behind the scenes. He may play a wild man on Game of Thrones, but Christopher admits he loves being a family man at home. He has been married to Gry Mulvaire Heavey since 2015. Another happily married Game of Thrones star is Jacob Anderson, who plays Grey Worm. Told you we would bring him up again. Most people don't know too much about his personal life, including the fact that he creates music under the name Raleigh Ritchie. Yes, Jacob is a multi-talented star, and he's one who has been happily married since 2018. This was the year he tied the knot with actress Aisling Loftus. So, we're sorry to disappoint you if you had any hope of a romance between him and Natalie. Aisling says she and Jacob are very happy together and are nothing but supportive of each other's careers. So what do you think of these adorable behind-the-scenes romances? Do you think Emilia Clarke is as single as she appears? Share your thoughts with us in the comment section below. Don't forget to click on the subscribe button to get access to all of the latest and greatest videos from us here at The Taco. Thanks for watching, and we'll see you again next time.